Hi, welcome back. Hôm nay mình muốn giúp các bạn luyện nghe listening skill. Một cái câu chuyện này mình kể cho các bạn rất là đơn giản. Mình dùng những cái câu đơn giản, cụm từ người bản xứ dùng nhiều với lại ngữ pháp cũng đơn giản luôn. Cái cách tốt nhất mình nghĩ các bạn học theo cái clip này là các bạn coi đi vài lần. Khi mình kể cho các bạn cái câu chuyện, các bạn hãy để ý cái phụ đề mình viết ở dưới nha. Mỗi câu các bạn thử lắng nghe mình, xong rồi đứng cái video lại, đọc cái tựa đề ở phía dưới. Sau đó các bạn có thể play ngược lại cái câu mình nói để coi các bạn nghe cái dính hay không. Mình nghĩ các bạn nếu học cái cách này, các bạn sẽ tập cái lỗ tai của các bạn nghe tiếng Anh nó dễ hơn. Trước khi mình vô chương trình, các bạn phải biết 3 điều. Điều thứ nhất là các bạn phải biết cái chuyện này là cái chuyện xảy ra trong quá khứ, cho nên mình dùng động từ quá khứ cho các bạn. Các bạn nhớ để ý động từ quá khứ nha. Cái điều thứ nhì mình muốn các bạn là các bạn để ý nối âm. Trong những cái câu, cái chữ màu đỏ là cái chữ mình muốn các bạn chú ý với cái dạng từ quá khứ. Còn chữ màu xanh thì cái đó là nối âm. Ví dụ cái câu này, I looked at her. Cái chữ look nó có màu xanh với màu đỏ là tại vì màu đỏ nó là dạng quá khứ, còn cái màu xanh là nối âm. Cái âm này phát âm là that. I looked at her, tại vì quá khứ của chữ look là looked. Cho nên khi chữ looked mà kế chữ at thì looked at, âm T. I looked at her. Cái điều thứ ba là các bạn nghe mình nhấn âm ngay chỗ nào, cái câu mình nhấn như sao. Các bạn hãy bắt chước cái cách mình nói chuyện. Mình biết cái điệu ngữ mỗi người nó hơi khác nhau, mà khi các bạn mới học tiếng Anh thì các bạn phải bắt đầu từ đâu? Thì bắt đầu bắt chước mình trước cái đó. Trong tương lai khi tiếng Anh của các bạn giỏi, sành điệu, thì các bạn tự lập cái ngữ điệu của mình riêng. Điệu ngữ hay ngữ điệu? Thêm một cái điều nữa, mấy cái câu trong cái chuyện này các bạn lấy nó làm cái nền nha. Làm cái nền là sao? Là các bạn hãy thuộc cái câu đó, xong rồi các bạn chỉ cần đổi cái chữ để làm cho câu của các bạn trong cái chuyện của các bạn riêng. Ví dụ cái câu, a few years ago, I was at the mall doing Christmas shopping. Khi mà các bạn thuộc cái câu này mình nói ra cho các bạn làm nền cho nó để những cái câu của các bạn riêng. Các bạn có thể đổi nó là, a few days ago, I was at the supermarket. Hoặc là a few hours ago, I was at the park. Ví dụ cái câu I opened my eyes and looked at her thì các bạn có thể thay đổi rằng là I opened my mouth and spoke. Okay, let's go. This is my embarrassing story. It's a true story. A few years ago, I was at the mall trying to do my Christmas shopping. I went into a store called Brookstone. They sell nice, interesting things there. The store was really crowded because of the holiday season. I went in, I looked around, and on display, there was a bed. They weren't selling the bed, actually. They were selling the mattress. It was a new kind of mattress. It was really nice. I was really curious of this new mattress and wanted to see for myself. I walked over to the bed to take a closer look. Then I sat on it. It was really comfortable. I liked it a lot. Then I lay down on it to see how comfortable it was. It was great. It was soft, but not too soft. It was perfect. In fact, I didn't want to get up because the mattress felt really nice. As I was lying there, people walked by. They were looking at me. I thought to myself, probably they were looking at the new mattress as well. I began to close my eyes. A few minutes later, there was this young, pretty employee walked by. She came over, she stood next to the bed looking down at me. I opened my eyes, I looked up. My eyes met hers, her eyes met mine. I looked at her, she looked at me, and she said something to me. I couldn't hear because the place was very crowded and noisy. She said it again, and I still couldn't hear her. Then I slowly got up. I stood next to her. I leaned closer to hear what she was trying to say. When I did that, she whispered into my ear. She said, "Sir, your zipper is open." My face turned red. I quickly zipped up my pants and I got out of there really fast. Sau nghe cái câu chuyện này rồi, sau khi mà các bạn đọc cái phụ đề ở phía dưới để ý những cái quá khứ, những cái nối âm, bây giờ các bạn trở ngược lại video, các bạn play nó lại từ đầu tới cuối mà đừng có ngừng nó, với lại đừng có đọc cái phụ đề nha. Các bạn thử làm vậy nha, nghe coi nó dính không ha. Okay, that's it. I'll see you next time. Hi, welcome back. Tiếp tục listening skill, luyện nghe. Cái clip này cái level nó hơi cao hơn một tí xíu cho nên các bạn phải chăm chú nha. Khi các bạn xem cái video này, các bạn nhớ để ý cái phụ đề ở phía dưới với lại để ý cái chữ mình viết bằng màu nha. Cái chữ màu đỏ thì mấy cái động từ quá khứ mình muốn các bạn để ý đến. Còn chữ màu xanh là những cái nối âm hoặc là cái chữ đó mình rút ngắn lại hoặc là cái chữ đó mình lướt qua mình thấy quan trọng khi mà speaking hoặc là listening. Những bạn còn yếu tiếng Anh hoặc là còn yếu listening skill thì các bạn xem những câu mình xong rồi quay ngược lại xem đi xem lại cái câu đó. Các bạn nhớ để ý tại sao mình dùng cái đó chữ quá khứ hoặc là các bạn nhớ để ý cái cách mình nối âm hai chữ với lại cái âm xì. Khi mà các bạn luyện nghe tiếng Anh nhiều, lỗ tai của các bạn càng ngày nó càng bén lên. Các bạn để ý mấy cái chữ có hai màu đó nha. Ok, ready? Let's begin. Hôm nay mình trả lời một cái câu. Why do I make YouTube videos? That's easy. I wanna be famous like Lady Gaga. I wanna have lots of wives and girlfriends. And the money, it's great. Not really. So why do I make videos to help you learn English? A few years ago, I started out helping online friends learning English in a chat room. It wasn't the main reason I was there. I actually wanted to look for girls. I mean online friends. Yeah, online friends. Soon after that, I realized that English is becoming really important, especially to young people, and it's becoming a popular second language in Vietnam. If a person knows English, he or she can look for a job more easily, especially in tourism and hospitality. So English is everywhere, especially online. We can't get away from English. Students in higher education need English in order to read books, documents, and researches. Because most written works in higher education are written in English. Since I know English, I think I would like to help. I cannot replace your real English classes or your real English teachers in Vietnam. I hope that I can make things easier for you, especially in pronunciation. My goal is to make your pronunciation as natural as possible. Also, I hope to answer some confusion you might have. If I can do that, I think you'll be happy and your teachers will be happy too. And I'll be happy too. I understand completely of your struggle in learning English. It's a crazy language. It's fun, but it's crazy. I've been through it when I was a kid. I understand being a kid and learning a new language is easier than being older and learning a new language. I completely understand that. And that's why I sympathize with you and I'm happy to help. YouTube seems to be the perfect medium for this, and I'm glad I can be able to make videos. I know a lot of people have thanked me for my videos. Please let me return the favor by thanking you and have given me the honor for being a teacher online. Although I'm not a teacher, I'm just a handsome lover. So here's the deal. I'll pretend to be a teacher and take some honor you've given me. And in return, I'll help you to learn more English. Sounds like a good deal to me. And thanks for listening. I'll see you next time. Hi, welcome back. Hôm nay mình tiếp tục giúp các bạn listening skill, luyện nghe. Mình nghĩ nhiều bạn cần luyện nghe cho nên mình làm video này tiếp. Các bạn nhớ để ý cái phụ đề mình viết phía dưới nha. Chữ màu xanh là nối âm hoặc là cái chữ nào đó mình thấy quan trọng các bạn nên để ý một tí xíu. Còn chữ màu đỏ là những cái động từ quá khứ mình muốn các bạn cũng để ý luôn nè. Các bạn ráng nghe nha, nhiều khi các bạn phải xem lại 2-3 lần để cho các bạn nghe cho dính. Luyện nghe là vậy đó, mình phải nghe cho quen, quen ngữ điệu, quen từ vựng, quen những cái từ mà thông thường trong tiếng Anh họ dùng hàng ngày. Cái bài này mình nói tốc độ bình thường một tí xíu để cho các bạn ráng tập nghe nha. Các bạn đừng có lo, cứ thư giãn, relax, nghe giọng đẹp trai của mình, sau đó từ từ các bạn sẽ nghe dính nè. Tựa đề là Things About Me. Me. First of all, I'm handsome. And if you haven't noticed, you better notice. Look at me. Is this the face of a movie star or what? I was born in Tiền Giang province in Vietnam in a little town called Gò Công. It's a tiny place. You probably haven't heard of it. The town is so small that everybody knows everybody. My town is famous for its handsome young men. I came to the US when I was 7 or was it 8? I forgot. I grew up in California nearly all my life. I have a third grade education when it comes to Vietnamese. That is the reason why my Vietnamese is not that great. I have a lot of toys. I like toys because I'm young. I'm still young. Honestly, I think they're nice and cute. Oh, look at these. They're so cute. Oh. Hi, Spider-Man. Hi, Superman. Spider-Man, I like you to meet Superman. Superman, I like you to meet Spider-Man. I especially like comic book toys because I grew up reading comic books. I read and collected a lot of comic books when I was a kid, especially Batman, Spider-Man, Iron Man, X-Men, Superman. Many of you know these characters from movies recently, but all of them were from comic books. Another thing about me is that I can't sing. I know, you're surprised. I have a face of a movie star and a voice of honey. Hey ladies. But somehow when I sing, I sound like a dying cat. So if you ever take me to karaoke, you'll be disappointed. I like to laugh because life is depressing and sad enough already. If I want to be sad, I think about my love life. I also like science fiction movies because I think they're cool. I like to eat mam. Mắm, mình thích ăn mắm. I love mắm, mắm tôm, mắm Thái, mắm ruốc, nước mắm, bún mắm, mắm kho. I don't know why I like it, but it just tastes good. Anything that has the word mum, I wanna put it in my mouth. When I was a kid, I remember the first time I tried mum, I loved it right away. Yeah, so I love mum. Okay, the next thing about me is I have a political science degree. Yes, you heard it right. Political science degree. It doesn't help me to flirt with girls. I should have studied the guitar. The next thing about me is I am the only child. Yes, the only child. I have no brothers or sisters, which makes me lonely. The final thing about me is I'm left-handed. Left-handed people are intelligent and handsome. President Obama is left-handed, and former President Clinton, he's left-handed. They are both smart and handsome. So my conclusion is I am... Don't even answer. Okay, that's enough about me. Thanks for listening, and I'll see you next time. Hi, welcome back. Okay, listening skill number 4. 5, 4. Today, I'm gonna tell you about my city. Trước khi mình bắt đầu, các bạn hãy để ý chữ phụ đề ở dưới nha. Chữ màu xanh là những cái chữ mà mình muốn các bạn để ý đến. Mấy chữ đó thường khi là nối âm, hoặc là lướt âm, hoặc là cái gì quan trọng đó mình muốn các bạn chú ý đến. Thêm một điều nữa, nhiều bạn hỏi rằng là những video trước luyện nghe, sau có lúc mình không nối âm, có lúc mình nối âm. Các bạn phải hiểu rằng là khi mình nối âm, mình phải nói nhanh, gọn, tốc độ giao tiếp. Có những lúc mình nói chậm để các bạn nghe dễ. hơn. Với lại là nhiều khi mình muốn nhấn mạnh cái gì đó trong câu, thì khi mà mình gặp cái âm nói thì mình không có nói âm đó. Các bạn nhớ nha, nói âm là phải nói nhanh, gọn. Còn khi mình nói chậm thì mình không có nói âm nhiều. Bởi vậy nhiều khi các bạn không có nghe mình nói âm là lý do đó đó. Okay, let's begin. Like I said, I'm gonna tell you about my city. I live in the city of Sacramento, California, USA. California. Nhà nha. California. California is a state. Sacramento is a city in the state. If you pronounce the word Sacramento faster, it sounds like Sacramento. I live in Sacramento. But we like to shorten it further to Sacto. I live in Sacto. Sacto is a quiet, medium-sized city. It's not as well known as other Californian cities like Los Angeles or San Francisco or San Diego. We're not as bustling as Los Angeles or as scenic as San Francisco. And the weather is not as beautiful as San Diego's. Not very many Vietnamese in Vietnam have heard of Sacramento. So what's so special about Sacramento? Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Oh, I gotta get out of this place. Not a lot of people know this, but Sacramento is the capital of California. This is where the state government is located. The governor of California lives and works here, and so do many of other politicians. We have the Capitol building. It's a nice place. I'll show it to you one day. We also have Old Sacramento or Old Sacto. It's like a little cowboy town. It's pretty nice too. In Sacto, we have museums and shopping malls and many places for you to eat. We have one tiny, narrow river, several lakes, and a handsome guy who lives here. The weather can be quite hot here, sometimes reaching up to 44 degrees Celsius. Yes, 44. Do you know why? Because I'm hot, and I make the weather hot. And in the winter, it can go below zero. But most of the year, the weather is quite good. The air here is cleaner than in LA. LA, that's Los Angeles. We have more open space than San Francisco. And the cost of living here is lower than other big cities. So it's really nice to raise a family here. Where are we located in California? We're located a little north of California, between San Francisco and the Sierra Mountain. From Sacto, head west if you wanna go to San Francisco. Head east if you wanna go to the mountain. I don't recommend you go south because there is a big desert down there. But if you survive, you'll reach Los Angeles. North of Sacramento is farmland. Lots and lots of farmland. If you like to eat vegetable, then head up north. In conclusion, I live in a boring city. Okay, that's it. I'll see you next time.
That IELTS test? That was a piece of cake. Cái idiom này trường hợp nào dùng cũng được, nhất là trong không khí vui vẻ. Nếu mình dùng nhiều quá trong cái không khí nghiêm túc thì người ta có...
Okay, let's go to San Francisco. The trip usually takes about 2 hours. The driving was great until I hit a traffic jam. More traffic jam. In the end, it took me about 3.5 hours to get there. And then more traffic jam. And this here is the beautiful Bay Bridge entering San Francisco. It's also the main entrance to the city. And here is the main section of the bridge. Welcome to San Francisco. Finally, I made it. San Francisco is a bustling city. Driving here is more difficult than driving in my city, but I had help from my cousin. While he was driving, I just enjoyed the views. Now, Our first stop is the Golden Gate Bridge. People from all over the world visit here. They want to take a closer look at the bridge. And that is the Golden Gate Bridge. And here is the statue of Joseph Strauss, the chief engineer of the bridge. As you can see, there are pictures, diagrams, and information for tourists to learn about the bridge. So if you are interested in the history and the design of the bridge, then this place is for you. And here is the section of the cable of the bridge on display. Packed inside this cable are more than 27,000 wires. And where are the cables on the bridge? Here they are. San Francisco weather is very unpredictable. Even though this is in the middle of the summer, it was 16 degrees Celsius. And this is a beautiful shot of the bridge against the sun and the fog. And the two handsome guys. From the bridge, we can see the beautiful San Francisco Bay. And that is the city of San Francisco. Why is the Golden Gate Bridge is so famous? It was built in 1937. It's about 2.7 kilometers long. It was considered an engineering achievement at the time. There were no computers or modern technology to help. Every day, about 100,000 cars cross this bridge. We walked till we reached to the first of the two pillars. We didn't actually walk the whole length of the bridge because I was too old. I mean too tired. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the view of the San Francisco Bay. Fog is quite common here. Luckily for us, there was not a lot of fog today, so we were able to film it. It was windy, we were cold, so we decided to go back. And we're back at the tourist area. Oh, this is a great view. I hope you liked the video. It was fun to film. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. San Francisco is very scenic. It's hilly and it's near the ocean. The view is amazing at every turn. Since many people want to live here, the houses are expensive. If I have a lot of money, I'd live here. Okay, let's go to our next stop, Lombard Street. This is the famous Lombard Street on the map. As you can see, it has a unique zigzag shape. It's said that Lombard Street is the crookedest street in the world. And we are about to drive on Lombard Street. This one-way street was built back in 1922. It's about 183 meters long, with 8 tight turns. The reason it was designed this way is to reduce the steepness of the hill. That way, it's easier for people and vehicles to go up and down the hill. There's something special about this street. Perhaps it's cute and pretty with beautiful houses on each side. Or perhaps it's rare to see a street like this. Whatever the reason, it has become one of the symbols of San Francisco. I've come here many times, and each time is just as interesting as the first. It doesn't take a lot of time to visit this place. In fact, you don't even need to get out of your car. Just get on the street and enjoy the slow drive down. Looking out from Lombard Street, we can see the Bay Bridge in the distance. There are people who actually live in these houses. They have to put up with hundreds of tourists who come here each day. Tourists come here to take pictures and to walk up and down the winding street. As you can see, cars line up to get a chance to go down the street. It was a beautiful afternoon, perfect weather for this attraction. Can you believe it? It's crowded like this every day. It's estimated that every 10 seconds, a car passes through Lombard Street. Okay, let's have one continuous ride down Lombard Street. Are you dizzy yet? Because I am. San Francisco is a great city. It's quite small when comparing to other famous American cities, but its size is perfect to explore its beauty in a short time. I hope to return here to make some more videos for you. That's it, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Here is Vietnam. And here is where I live, Sacramento, California. My vacation took me across the country to Washington, D.C., the capital of the United States. Our first stop was the Martin Luther King Jr. Memorial. This site was opened in 2011. You might be asking, who was Martin Luther King Jr.? Martin Luther King Jr. was a civil rights leader. He and many others fought for full equality in America during the 1960s. It's hard to believe, but back then, the law did not treat blacks and whites equally. African Americans were discriminated. For example, blacks were forced to sit at the back of the bus. Many restaurants did not welcome blacks. And many universities did not allow black students to attend. The civil rights movement changed all that. Because of the civil rights movement, the law treats everyone equally. Sadly, he was assassinated in 1968. This memorial is dedicated to him. His statue looks across the river toward the Jefferson Memorial. We will visit that place in another video. Carved in these walls are some of his famous quotes. He was a great speaker, and his speeches were inspirational to the people. And just a handsome guy leaning against the wall. Our next stop is the Lincoln Memorial. This is a very popular site to visit in Washington, D.C. It faces the Reflection Pond and the Washington Monument. Okay, let's go up there to visit the 16th American president, Abraham Lincoln. Lincoln is considered to be one of the greatest and the most important American presidents. He presided over the American Civil War from 1861 to 1865 to unify the country and end its slavery. Lincoln was very intelligent and wise. Unfortunately, he was assassinated after the war. Here's another look toward the Washington Monument. Okay, let's go inside and see what's in there. Inside, we see the statue of Lincoln sitting down, and the tourists crowding it to have their pictures taken. People from all over the world come here. I could hear many languages spoken among the crowd. Lincoln is probably one of the most recognizable presidents. With his thin face, his beard, and his big ears. He's on the $5 bill and the 1 cent coin, which is the penny. Let's pan the camera around for you to see. And here is his short but most famous speech, the Gettysburg Address. That speech helped to unite and to reconcile the nation after the war. And the last look at the Lincoln Memorial before we go. Let's head to another site. Our final site for this video is the Korean War Memorial. The Korean War is also known as the Forgotten War, because not many Americans mentioned this war. The war took place from 1950 to 1953. The US and South Korea fought against North Korea, and it ended in a stalemate. Even to this day, the war has not officially ended. I find this place very eerie. Here, statues of soldiers look on with their solemn faces. If you like history, you will surely love Washington, D.C. American history is very short. It's only a little over 200 years, so it's easy to learn. I hope you like the tour, and I hope you've learned a little bit about American history. Okay, that's it. I'll see you next time. Hi, welcome back. These are called jack-o'-lanterns. You might have seen them before. They represent Halloween. In America, people put them in front of the houses during Halloween. They come in all kinds of designs. Some are scary. Some are funny. Many are creative. For this year's Halloween, I will show you how to make one. Let's try. Jack-o'-lanterns are made from pumpkins. So we are going to use this nice plump pumpkin I bought. Actually, I bought two of them, just in case I mess up. I bought these for $5 each at my local supermarket. Okay, make sure you pick a pumpkin with a nice looking stem. The skin or the rind should be bright orange and fresh. Before we begin, we need a few things. I bought a carving kit and lights. The kit contains a long serrated knife, a pen to draw on the pumpkin, a small serrated knife, and a scooper. And finally, we will use these lights when we are done. Before we begin to carve, we need to pick a good spot for the face. I prefer the bulging side of the pumpkin. First, I'm gonna draw the face. Here, I can be as creative as I want. I'll draw the eyes. Let's give him big eyes. Then the mouth. Let's give him a grinning mouth. This pen is too cheap. Let's use a better one. Here is the rough outline of the face. Not bad looking. Now I need to get inside of the pumpkin. In order to do that, I'm going to cut around the stem. This will also create a top for the jack-o'-lantern. I simply cut into the pumpkin and follow the line. Once done, I gently lift up the newly cut top. Here we see some pumpkin seeds. Now, this is the hardest and the most tiring part. I need to take out all the seeds and thin out the pumpkin meat. This step will be messy. It smells nice though. I like the smell. Using a scooper, I'm going to thin out the pumpkin meat. This scooper is terrible. I'll use my ice cream scooper instead. You can use a strong spoon if you don't have an ice cream scooper. Keep working around inside by scraping off the pumpkin wall. Make sure you thin out the wall evenly. Don't make it too thin or else your jack-o'-lantern will be weak and it will dry out quickly. Keep on scooping and scraping. Scoop and scrape. Scoop and scrape. Don't forget the top. I think that is good enough. Here is what the inside looks like. Nice and clean. Okay, let's carve out the face of the jack-o'-lantern. I like this part the most. Simply puncture through the pumpkin and follow the lines. And gently detach any pieces coming off from it. Here is his new grin. Now I take my time to make him look better, making sure his face is as handsome as mine. And we are done carving. Okay, let's see what he looks like with the top on. Here's the proud artist and his work. Finally, let's light this guy up. You can use a small flashlight or any small light. Traditionally, people use candles to light them. If you use a candle, you should not put the top on, or else it will catch fire. Not bad, in fact, it looks great. Let's have a little more fun and use a color-changing light. And there it is. I made a jack-o'-lantern for Halloween. I hope you liked the video and thanks for watching. And happy Halloween! Every Christmas, I would go into my closet and pull out my old Christmas tree. As you can see, it's not a real tree, but it's really pretty and it looks real. This is the spot I've decided to put the tree this year. First, we need to set up the stand for it. Next, we will assemble the tree. It's quite easy to put together. It comes in three parts. And it's heavy. In all, the tree weighs about 22 kilos. Here I am making sure the branches look natural and are not crooked. Okay, we are done with the first part. Next, we need to decorate the tree. Here I am at a supermarket buying some Christmas decoration for it.
This time of the year, nearly every store sells holiday decoration. These are called ornaments. We hang these on Christmas trees. They come in many shapes and sizes and designs and prices. Cartoon characters. Ice cream cone. Reindeer. Elephant. And some I don't even know. Here are wrapping papers for gifts. And bows and ribbons. These are decorative stockings. I'll take one of these. Christmas ball ornaments are very popular. I'll take some as well. These are called wreaths. People hang them on the outside of their front doors. Okay, here are my ornaments for this year. Few are new, but most of them are old from years ago. A red bird. A birdhouse. A snowman. Another snowman. Santa Claus in white. I need this the most in my life. Birds again. I painted it in school when I was in third grade. I've kept it ever since. This is not a Christmas ornament, but I'll use it as an ornament because it looks pretty and, more importantly, it was on sale. Here's a closer look at some of them. Okay, back to the tree. For this tree, the lights are already attached to it. Looking good so far. I want more lights, color lights. The star goes on top of the tree. To make the tree look nicer, I tried to hide the string as much as possible. Okay, let's turn on all of the lights. Nice. Here is the close-up of the tree. Pretty. Okay, let's decorate it. I like this part the most. The snowman goes here. Love goes here. The red bird sits here, and the monster here. The tree needs some color with these. And these. Lastly, I want to use these lighted branches. Here I gather all the Christmas presents from friends and family and put them under the tree. Let's turn on the lights again, this time with full decoration. Thanks for watching. I hope you like it. Merry Christmas, everyone. Late Christmas. Huh. Now I have to clean up the carpet. No problem, I have my robot vacuum cleaner for that job.
Okay, let's go.
Hi.
Winnie. I was gonna like not wear my glasses.
Ah, that's alright.
You look intellectual with glasses.
I look like 10 years older with glasses.
Okay, you gonna drive?
Don't take it.
What is...
We're gonna get your car washed.
Wait until we get out first.
I wanna go in there.
Look.
Ooh.
Make sure you leave your knife and guns outside.
Lighter, cigarettes? I need the lighter.
You have lighter?
Yeah.
All right, we are in. Yay.
Yay!
Yeah, I think we missed the military airplanes. Let's get into the plane over there.
Okay.
It's so loud here. I don't think anybody can hear us. Holy cow, look at that. Gigantic. Look at that. It doesn't look big on TV, but when you come up close, it's pretty big. Right, let's get in there.
Alright, so we're inside of this cargo plane. Look at that.
Can you get a good picture
for your book? Hey, get away!
So, how do you like the air show so far?
It's fun.
It's just fun.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, that's
big
great.
Planes.
Yeah, big plane, small plane.
Hello. We're in line
for to where?
The top of the plane.
The top of the plane. Which is called?
The top of the plane.
It's cockpit. The cockpit. Yeah. It's gonna be a while though. The line is pretty long. Big plane. It's really big. It's a big plane.
Probably
it's,
put
it's
like
probably bigger than my house.
100 people in here.
Oh yeah. Definitely. What's your name?
Ben.
Ben, I'm Kenny. Hey Ben. Let's go up.
Yeah, but you can't do anything else, right? Just go up.
Oh, I see. But you're British.
Hello. There are big planes.
Look, you can go in there. All right, let's get inside the airplane. We get in. All right, let's go. So Fiona's hungry. We're gonna find some food for her.
Yeah.
Alright, what do you feel like?
I don't know. Maybe pizza.
Pizza, hot dog, burger, which one?
Thank you. There you go, thank you.
So what do you think about the show?
Good,
And what do you think?
It was loud. Lots of planes.
Planes.
Very patriotic.
Loud. Yes, that's the word. Hot. Alright, so we're gonna have a long walk. It's gonna be a while. I'm kinda tired. How are you?
No, it's just hot and sunny.
It's hot. Okay.
My feet kinda hurt.
Oh. How many photos did you take?
I don't know, a lot. Let's have a look at the souvenirs for a second.
Alright, I have no more money for souvenir.
These are kids shirts. This is what it looks like. We also have adult shirts, and then we have a shirt like that with for males and one for females with pink cat.
Okay, alright, we'll look around then. Yeah, look at that one. Yeah, we're gonna do a little performance. Yeah. Oh, I had this when I was a kid.
Yeah.
I had the same thing.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Did
need you to sign on this one.
Okay.
So we're gonna go get you a car wash.
And it really needs it.
Yes.
Did you take a video of it?
Yes, I am.
No, I said, did you take a video of my car?
Yeah, earlier I did.
Oh.
And we know how dirty it was.
When you go places, that's what happens.
That's true. I need to go to places.
I haven't been in a car wash in like years. I can't even remember.
Oh, really?
Ultimate wash?
Yes, ultimate. Oops.
Please make your selection. Please wait while your transaction is being processed.
So there you go.
Oh my god, so excited. Washing my car. Oh, there's still poo on that corner there. I hope he gets it out.
Yeah, we'll get it out. Alright, so there's a dryer over there. Exit slowly, okay? So go forward. Who are you?
My name is Kelly.
So, where are we going again?
Get some to eat.
Okay, eat and then what?
After that, we're gonna get a Christmas tree.
Christmas tree, okay.
Hi! And welcome back for Kenny and channel.
Oh my god, there's our name! Kenny G. And
this is Kenny G and
wait,
company.
Wait.
Do you go here often?
Like sometimes. Not every time, but sometimes.
Two for lunch? Yes.
Alright, here you go.
Okay, alright, thanks. Look at this. Like, nobody here. Beer? You want a beer? No, okay.
Do you want any lemon in your water?
575 calories. I can't be fat. I want to look good. I want to be handsome. What?
Can I have spaghetti, please?
Mm-hmm. And then do you want the kids' portion or the adult portion?
So we have salad.
Mm-hmm. The salad.
And the bread.
How do you eat the bread?
You hold it.
Okay, you hold it. And then you bite it.
Yes, you bite it.
That's it, huh?
Mm. Scissors with a spoon.
Mm-hmm. You want some?
Yeah.
Some food?
I got spaghetti.
You want cheese?
Yes.
Let me know what's up.
There's only one meatball. Why can't they give you two? You want to share mine? That's mine, that's yours. We were alone, but now, look at this. So there's a bunch of people. I know everybody's here. So how are we gonna pay for this? I think you hit pay. So total is $30. What is that?
Santa Bell. That's snowflake.
Red snow. Blood snow. Hey, you gonna pick out the Christmas tree for me?
Yeah.
Okay. So this is the place.
Yeah.
Oh, look, that's the one with snow.
Oh.
Yeah. Let's go in there and see. Ooh. Oh, that looks nice. That's tall though. That's really tall. That's too fat. Okay, but we're gonna give a look around first. Oh, that's perfect. But it's sold. Actually, this looks nice. $100. Oh, this is... But it looks so ugly. Look at this. It's kind of messed up. $99. How much? How much is that? $84. Ouch.
How much is this?
Oops. It's $99. It's $100.
Oh, there's a tag.
How much?
$80.
Oh, this is perfect. Look. Perfect size. That is perfect size. Yeah.
There's space over here.
Aw, no! It's damaged. Well, you know what? We can hide this. We can turn this against the wall.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's we'll take
that.
This one.
So you want that one?
Yeah. So you're gonna climb up here and hold it while I'm driving, okay?
No,
thanks. Do you know any Christmas songs?
I sing Jingle Bell. 5, 6, 7, 8. Jingle Bell, Jingle Bell, Jingle Bell Rock. Jingle Bell, Swing, yeah, Jingle Bell. Wait, why I sing Jingle Bell Rock?
Jingle all the way.
Oh, okay, thank you, thank you. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle all the way. Wait, do I say right?
Mm-hmm.
Alright.
You're mixing two different songs.
Yes, one more try. Can you say it again?
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle all the way.
Okay. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell. Oh my gosh. Yeah, it looks heavy. He thinks it's heavy, right?
It's heavy. Okay, we got the tree here for now. We're gonna go and buy a stand. Ooh. Are you cold? No, you're drinking hot chocolate, you're not cold. So, they ran out of stands. We're gonna buy a bucket. Yeah, this is the one. This will work. Okay, alright. We're done.
This is my purse.
I like it. Is it Gucci or LV?
I don't know. But it's both.
Oh. You drank all of this.
Yes.
All of this is right there in your stomach.
Yes.
This is heavy for him. Like, how many pounds?
Okay.
Alright. Oh no, it made a mess! It made a mess!
Oh my god, it made a mess.
Oh!
Okay, we'll sweep that. Okay,
right. This is hard. Oh, wait, be careful! Be careful with the lights, it's really expensive.
Yo.
Got it?
Yeah.
I'm gonna turn it.
Nobody ever knows.
So this is the best side of the tree. You hardly know this tree is ugly now. Okay, after a lot of struggle, we finally got the Christmas tree up. The bucket looks good. It works. Pretty nice. These are the ornaments.
And
lights. I'm gonna help her with the lights first. And then she can do the ornaments. I'll help you. I'll help you. They work. Alright, you helped me with the lights. Yeah, huh?
It was hard.
Yeah, right.
So here is a purple one. Oh, this is a cute one. This is Snowflake.
Oh.
So we have a bell. And we have a little angel.
Angel, cute. Oh, the angel's broken. It's okay. Broken.
Oh no. There's a Santa Claus.
Okay. Santa Claus.
Cute. Oh, there's Minnie Mouse. Oh, little bird! And we have a leopard! Snowman head with a star!
That's a, yeah, snowman with the Santa hat. Very good. Okay, I'll help you.
Okay.
See? There you go.
Yay! I want to play.
Cute. Very nice. Cute. All right. Next.
Okay, I'm gonna put them here.
Okay.
Voila! The heart. Yay!
Nope. It's too heavy. No. Yeah, like that. Yay. There you go.
I think right here.
He's facing the wrong way.
Right here?
Yeah, there you go.
Right here?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you help me.
Minnie has no hook. She has to stand. Yeah, there you go.
I think right here.
Okay, that's fine.
The snowman.
Okay, snowman.
What's next?
Santa. We have plenty left. We're done! Yay!
Yes.
Look at that!
Bye everybody! Thanks for watching!
Hi, happy Halloween. Today I'm taking my niece trick-or-treating. Usually trick-or-treating takes place outside from house to house, but today we'll film at the mall. What's your name?
Kelly.
What's your name?
Jaden.
Who? What?
Jaden.
Jaden, okay.
And G-U-Y-E-N.
Very good. What about your last name? How do you spell your last name? NGO. Okay, very nice.
I am second grade.
You're in second grade. Okay. How old are you?
8.
How old are you?
5.
So who are you?
I'm Darth Vader, and this one is, remember?
Boba Fett.
Yeah.
Where's your handsome uncle?
In your candy, yeah. You hold it, you can release.
That's right. You want to get some candy?
Yeah. I got one candy.
All right, let's go. Did you say trick or treat?
Yeah, trick or treat.
Trick or treat?
And also I got stickers.
Cool.
And lemonade.
I think there was this much candy in Sacramento.
Take a couple. What'd you say? Say?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Did you say thank you yet?
You're welcome.
Tired?
No.
No? You can go all night?
Yeah.
Okay. I think I have the biggest camera here. Yeah. There you are.
She's shy.
It's getting heavy.
I know.
How are you?
Good. Oh my god.
He's weird.
It's weird.
But he's like a robot.
Give me half. You promised you can give me half.
Said,
can I have half your candy, huh?
Get one.
This only one?
This is coffee.
I want two.
This is coffee.
Give me more.
What?
More.
No.
More. That's not enough. Okay. Look what I found.
Hey, that's mine.
No. Okay. One for you.
Two.
One for me. Okay. Two for you. One, two for me.
That's
three
it.
Three for you. One, two.
No.
Three for me.
No.
Do you have any more you can give me?
No.
No.
Yeah.
All right, so we're gonna go.
To go stuff to eat.
So how many times have you been here?
Like 20, I think it's
20 times?
Actually like 21.
You eat more steak than I have.
Chicken strings.
Shrimp? Yes. You got it.
Can I have milk?
Absolutely.
Mashed potatoes.
You got it. Thank you.
You're welcome. 44, 45, 46,
46. Okay, stop. That's fine. Thank you. Thank you. That's fine. I know you can count. 99, 100. Yay!
Oh, that's a carrot cake.
Exactly.
It's new. Big.
Big mountain.
And chocolate
fudge cake.
I don't know what is it.
Who am I?
You're my gunner uncle.
Your handsome uncle, right? Okay.
Bye.
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 Bye.